Sige, so last time na in-apply natin yung method of joints para sa member AD saka AC. And then ngayon, isisolve na lang natin to ulit and then including the reactions para ma-run through talaga natin. Yan. So, dito sa point A, meron tayong hinge support. So, ilan yung reactions yan? Diba, merong dalawang reactions. So, meron tayong reaction, vertical reaction, AY. Tapos, meron ding horizontal reaction na sabihin natin, AX. Tapos, meron ding reaction sa B. This is a roller support. So, the reaction is purely vertical. Yan. And then, diba, we have to first resolve this load into components. So, yung 30 degrees, naka-incline with the vertical, ibig sabihin, ano yung component na to? Yan. This component is 100, then sine of 30 degrees. Again, this is sine, kasi with respect sa vertical yung angle natin. Then, the vertical component naman is going downward. Tapos, ito yung kadikit ng 30 degree na angle. So, this is 100 cosine 30. Yan. And then, for the distances, the figure is symmetrical. So, ibig sabihin, kapag 3 yan, ano yung distance na to? Yan. Dito na lang. This distance is essentially 8 minus 3, tapos divided by 2. Diba? So, yan. Project lang ako ng line dyan. So, sabi natin, x yan. Yung distance na yan. So, if this is x, itong dalawa, ibig sabihin, 8 yung total length from A to B. So, 8 minus 3, ilan yung matitira? Matitira is 5. So, 5, i-divide natin by 2 kasi dalawang sides. So, 8 minus 3, lagay ko na lang, divided by 2, this is 2.5 meters. So, ibig sabihin, this is 2.5 pala. Ayan, 2.5, saka ito rin, x equals 2.5 meters. Yan. Now, recall, nasa method of joints, nung sa joint A tayo, merong dalawang unknowns. But this, meron tayong way na masolve lahat using method of sections lang. But you will need two cuts. Dalawang cuts talaga yung gagawin natin. So, solve muna natin ulit yung AY. So, to solve AY, sana ako mag-moment. Diba sa point B? So, summing up moments about point B, we have AY multiplied by 8 meters, diba? So, AY times 8, clockwise yung rotation, kaya positive. And then, for the vertical component of the 100 kilonewton load, it will cause a counterclockwise rotation about point B. So, minus 100 cosine 30, then our moment arm is 3 plus 2.5, diba? Or simply, 5.5. Then next, we have ito, 100 sine 30, it will cause a clockwise rotation. Pag ito yung hawakan natin, yung ikot is pa-clockwise. So, plus 100 sine 30, then multiply natin by ano yung moment arm? Moment arm is 3 meters. This is 3 meters pala. Yan. So, equate to 0, AY is what? Isosolve na lang natin using our calculator para ma-orient ko kayo paano mag-store ng values. So, ito. Itong cashier na lang ha. Close ko muna. Yan. So, AY times 8, X times 8, then minus 100 cosine 30, multiplied by 5.5. And then plus 100 sine 30, then multiplied by 3. Equal yan dapat to 0. Yan, I think yan lang. So solving AY, we have 40.789. Now kahapon, ginawa natin yung 40.79. But now, to be conservative sa solutions natin, store na lang natin siya sa A. So to store a value, shift, store, yan, and then click the variable kung saan mo siya gustong i-store. So let's say, sa A ko siya ilalagay. Yan, so nakalagay na siya sa A. So if I will recall A, let's say ito, recall A. Yan, naka-store na siya. So, itong value na to, this is approximately 40.79. But the exact value is naka-store sa letter A. So, ilagay mo na lang na naka-store siya sa A para sa further calculations. Then next, to solve AX, we can sum up forces horizontal. So, summation of forces horizontal, we have AX, saan siya patungo? Patungo sa right, so positive. So AX, then 100 sine 30 is also going to the right. So plus din, plus 100 sine 30. Yan, equal 0. So yung AX, di ba magiging negative? Negative 50 kilonewtons. Now, negative, so ibig sabihin, mali yung assumption natin. Our assumption is to the right, so dapat pala to the left siya. Yan. And then, summation of forces along y, yan, makukuha na natin yung by naman. So, we have ay, tapos minus 100 cosine 30 for this vertical component. And then, plus by equals 0. Now, para yung by maging exact siya, gamitin natin yung nakastore kanina. So, yung ay nakastore sa a. So, gagawin ko, recall a, then minus 100 cosine 30. Yan, tapos plus by. Ito yung ano natin, so lagyan mo ng x. Yan, so solving x, we have 45.812. So, store natin yan sa b, kasi by. Yan. So, by equals 45.81. Kilonewtons. Positive yung lumabas, so this is acting upward. Yan, so ito na yung reactions natin. Again, naka-store to sa letter B. Shift store B. Ayan. So now, moving on, how can we apply the method of sections para sa members na to? So unahin natin yung AC. Ito. Solve the force in members AC, CD, and BC daw. So, paano yung AC? Ano yung cut natin? Again ha, the cut for method of sections doesn't have to be a straight line. So, it may be L, pwedeng V, pwede rin na, let's say, paganto yung cut po. Yan. Pwede rin pa ganyan. Now, for AC, yung magandang cut is to form an L cut. Ito yung gagawin natin. Yan. Pwede yan. Bakit? Explain pa. Kapag ito yung cut natin, di ba, maglalabasan yung internal forces. So, yung internal force ni AC, lalabas. Ito yung internal force ng AC. Yan. Tapos, yung internal force ng AD, ito na yan. Yan, internal force ng AD. Tapos, na-slice kasi to, so meron din yan siyang internal force. So, this one. Yan. So, paano natin kukunin yan? Yung force dyan. Saan tayo pwede mag-moment? Yan yung medyo mahirap. Kaya daw. Money ko lang ninyo sa assignment dili. Ang CD. Oh, ang easy. Wala, dili appeal sa assignment. Appeal ko na po ninyo. As a mission, pero gigamit ninyo ang line nga nakuha. Oh, dili, dapat. Moment ba? So, paano yan? Moment. Na para sa problem na to, medyo tricky siya. But pwede kang mag-moment sa point na to. Yan. Yan. Bakit? Yung force ng BC, tatama dyan. Yung force ng AD, tatama rin dyan. So makukuha mo yung AC. So, i-label natin to as A, B, C, D. What if i-label ko yan siya as point E. Yan. So, pag mag-moment ako sa point E, hindi nakasali yung BC saka, ano to? This is AD. So, yung AC na lang yung matitira. Yan. Again, ano nga yung ratio natin sa triangle AC? Yan. For triangle AC, ito yung triangle na i-consider natin. Yung triangle na yan. So, the horizontal distance is 2.5, while the height is 3. So, 2.5, 3. Tapos, ano yung hypotenuse niya? Hypotenuse will be square root of 61 divided by 2. Ayan. Essentially pala, pag sa left side ng cut yung i-consider natin, parang ito siya. Yan. Sa joint pala na to. Yan. Kahit naka-slice yan dyan, meron pa rin siyang internal force na intention. So again, pwede tayong mag-moment sa E kasi tatama silang dalawa. Yung BC saka AD. Now, we can resolve AC into components. Diba? So meron siyang vertical and horizontal component. So, what is the vertical component of AC? Diba, this is AC times what?
3
divided by square root of 61 over 2. Tama. Yan. And then, sa horizontal component naman, diba, this is AC then multiplied by 2.5 na divided by square root of 61 divided by 2. Yan. So, ang yung next problem is, ano yung moment arm patungo sa E? Yan yung isosolve natin. So, we want this distance. Yan. Itong distance na to. So, paano yan natin isolve? Yan yung next problem. So, to solve this distance, we need to apply ratio and proportion. Ito yung gagawin. We can use ratio and proportion for this triangle na parang itong buong triangle na to. Yan. And then, similar triangle kasi siya, kasi diba, the same slope yung triangle na to. Yan. Nagets lang ba? Bale, ito yung gagawin natin. Project na lang ako ng line dito para mas makita nyo talaga. Yan, project ako ng line dyan, saka dito rin. Yan. So, ano yung height niya? Height niya dyan. Ano yung height? Diba? 3. So, by ratio and proportion, let's relate the height by the base, x. Yan. So, the height of the large triangle is 3. The base is what? Diba? 2.5 plus 3, which is 5.5. Then, equate natin yan sa smaller triangle. Ito yung smaller triangle. Yan. So, what if I will label this as y? Yan, yung naka-purple na distance, this one, y. So, we have y. Tapos, ano yung base niya? The base is 4 meters. Ito. Yan. So, y divided by 4. So, what is y? Lagay na lang natin sa calculator. So, 3 divided by 5.5 equals... y divided by 4. So, alpha x divided by 4. Now, solving x, we have 2.18. Now, para magamit natin yung actual value talaga, what if i-store ko na lang siya sa variable y? Kasi merong variable y yung calculator natin. So, shift, store, tapos click nyo yung y. Ito, variable y. So, naka-store na siya sa y. Yan, para mas intuitive yung solution natin. So, ay naka-store sa a, b naka-store sa, by naka-store sa b, and then the distance y naka-store din sa y. So, bati sa gano'n nga, ang cy, nyo ibutang sa b. Kami mabuang o track ana. So, ikuan lang, i-store siya according to the variable. So, y is 2.18, approximately. But again, naka-store siya sa variable y. Ito yung gagamitin natin sa calculations. Yan. So, let's take moments about point A. Yan, considering this figure. So, itong AX, diba, alam natin na this is going to the left. Yung na-solve natin kanina. So, 50 kilonewtons. Palitan nyo na lang yung arrow. So, AX equals 50. AY naman is 40.79. But again, naka-store yan sa letter A. Yan. So, moment about E. So, we have AX. Ano yung moment arm ng AX patungo sa point E? Diba, yung distance Y. So, 50 yung AX, it will cause a clockwise rotation about E. So, bale, 50 times y. Yan. And then, plus ay times, ano yung moment arm ng ay? Patungo sa E. Diba? 4. Yan, 4 lang, kasi patungo lang dyan. So, ay times 4. And then, the vertical component of AC will cause a clockwise rotation pa rin. So, plus AC, then times the vertical component, I mean vertical distance, divided by square root of 61 divided by 2. This one. Ano yung moment arm niya? Moment arm niya is 4 meters going to point E. So, multiply natin yan by 4. And then, how about the horizontal component of AC? What will be the rotation? Counterclockwise. So, minus AC, and then, tapos, ano yan? 2.5 divided by square root of 61 divided by 2. Tapos, ano yung moment arm? Moment arm is the distance y. Diba? So, times y equals 0. So, the way I will type this sa calculator, since naka-store yung AY sa kaway, ito yan. 50 times recall Y for this one. Then, plus AY times 4, AY naka-store sa A. Then, multiplied by 4. Then, plus AC, alpha X times 3 divided by i-parenthesis na lang natin. Square root of 61 divided by 2. Yan. Then multiplied by 4. Ito. Then minus AC, x pa rin, kasi yan yung ano natin, times 2.5 divided by square root of 61 divided by 2. Then we have to multiply this by the distance recon y. Ayan. Sige, so equate to 0, solve natin yung AC. We have 162.427. Check down natin. Yan. So, di ba, exact talaga. 162.428. Yan. Kapag 3 decimal places. So, hearing item, this will dipangitaan sa YouTube. Kay gamay rag mo discuss o gingani nga pagi. So, ang AC is ila to? It was negative, yeah, negative 162.428 kilonewtons. This is in what? In compression. Kasi negative yung lumabas. Yan. Naka-follow lang?
Yes.
Ano yung ibang item na medyo mahirap? Yung CD, di ba? So, for CD, iba naman yung cut natin. Ito yung cut kapag sa CD tayo. Tatanggalin ko to. And then, let's label this as point E. Yan. So, para sa CD, yung cut ko is magiging ganito. Yan yung cut natin. So, it will expose the internal forces in members AD, AC, and CE. So, ito yung maglalabasa na internal forces. This one, and also this one. Lalabas yung internal forces niya. But notice na medyo mahirap siya pag sa left side tayo magko-consider. Mas madali sa right side kasi isang loading lang. Only BY. Diba? So what if yung right side na lang yung i-consider ko? So, ano nga yung BY? BY is 45.81. 45.81. Yan. So, para sa CD pala, mas maganda pag dito na lang tayo mag-moment. So, ito yung force ng CD kapag from the right. Again ha, acting away from the joint lahat. So, ito rin, acting away sa joint. Tapos, BC, acting away din sa joint. Yan. So, ito yung CD. This is CE. Ito naman yung, not CE pala. BC pala. BC. Then, this is AD. Yan. Now, still the same concept. Sa E tayo mag-moment. Kasi yung BC and AD, tatama sila sa point E pareho. So, solving CD, maikli lang yung solution natin. Ito yung solution. I-move ko to. Yan. Para sa CD, still the same, mag-moment tayo sa point E. Equal to 0. But, we are considering the right side of the section. So, just indicate in your solution, na you are considering the right side of the cut or simply right na lang. So, taking moments about E, considering the right, huwag mo nang isali lahat ng forces sa left side ng slice mo. So, ito, hindi na yan kasali lahat. So itong CD, ano yung moment arm niya patungo sa point E? Rotation muna. The rotation it will cause is counterclockwise. So negative CD, tapos i-multiply ko by, di ba, yung distance na yan, which is 3 minus y, di ba? So CD times 3 minus y. Tapos, we have PY, ano yung rotation na makakos niya? Counterclockwise. So minus BY, then ano yung moment arm? Moment arm is 4 meters, kasi sa gitna lang tayo nag-moment. So BY times 4 equals 0. Napaka-ikli lang ng solution compared if mag-joint ka, mag-joint method. So, solving CD, we have negative x times 3 minus y, then minus by, nakastore yan sa b, times 4 equals 0. So solving CD, we have negative 223.976. This is kilonewtons, tapos compression. Yan. So again ha, pwede ka mag-moment kahit saan. Pwede outside the truss. Pwede rin na within the truss. Kung meron ka makikita na point of intersection, pwede kang mag-moment dyan. So, pag-check natin siya sa app natin. Member CE, di ba? So, 223.976. Exact talaga yung nakuha natin. Yan. Tapos, compression. Yan. Thank you.